तस्मै श्री गुरवे अंचा कल्पतरुभ्यस्य कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय कदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय पदभक्ताय भक्त्या विहीन अपराध पुत्रेति तन्मयतया सर्वोऽपि and again same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Om Vishnu Pad Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami. We are now explaining very high class of Harikatha. It is very rare in old world. Very. I think not only this world but universe also. I have explained the aim and object of our life and also of our bhakti. It is very hard to understand all this because it has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam and Gita and everywhere. Manushyanam sahasresu kaschit jagati. Also somewhere in lakh-lakh. Muktanam api otishvapi mahamuni. But to tell thousand, Kotiswapi. Kotiswapi in English?
Ten millions.
Out of 10 millions, one can be, or also it cannot be. So you can think how rare is that object. What you are putting? Give your attention to him, not to anyone.
Maharaj ji, एक बंदी है, नीचे rehearsal चल रहा है वो drama का, और वो लोग अभी कथा सुनने नहीं आ रहे हैं।
तो मरे, तो हम क्या करें? Drama करते रहे सारा जीवन? Drama करते रहे वो drama करें, वो हरि कथा नहीं सुनेंगे। ड्रामा की क्या जरूरत है? यदि हरी कथा नहीं सुना तो ड्रामा तो करते ही रहते हैं। आई एम नॉट कम टू सी ड्रामाज एंड बट हियरिंग क्लासेज एंड देन डूइंग ड्रामा नो बट इफ एन वन इज नॉट हियरिंग एंड देयर ड्रामा सो मेनी टाइम्स नो इंस्पिरेशन विल कम नेवर इट विल कम नो इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ड्रामा विदाउट हरी कथा. So better they should do or not, they should come here and do here.
Very rare.
So I think that you are also like rare. In millions one have come. But in this also, I know that rare will hear attentively. And those who are hearing this, very rare will be, follow all these things. In practice, try to follow. This object is so hard. So the process to attain it is also very rare and very high. If you want to buy an ass, not so much money needed. But if you want to buy a high class of horse or elephant, then more needed. Even in this world. So this is most precious. So many universes, the process is there also to follow. One can hear something, but to totally follow, very rare. But still we are telling, we are discussing in this mall, so many audience. I don't know how many will understand and how will follow this path. If they cannot give up a smoke, coffee, even an insignificant tea, how they can have attained? How they can? If they cannot give up a penniless thing and they want so high class of precious thing, they want chintamani, more than chintamani. They are foolish. They are very foolish. It has been told for Krishna consciousness, if anyone is to give his neck, head, for high class of association, at once give up. Krishna bhakti rasa bhavita mati kriyatam pati tatra laulyam api melyam ekalam janma koti sukriti na. Those who are like this, I should take and test worldly things also, and that thing also, transcendental. Both cannot be done at a time, never. Can you laugh and
blow your cheek?
Blow your
cheek.
And laugh? At a time it cannot be. So you have to follow all this. So the process of bhakti is also rare. And you have to pay so much your most favorite things for Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left his wife, so hot and dear and even mother. And we cannot give up a tea or a cup of coffee. What is this? So you have to pay something, otherwise this high class of gold, How can we attain? If you are not sacrificing, oh, you cannot attain. Any day you have to sacrifice. You see, Raghunathdas Goswami, what he did? Everything, all position, all wealth, beautifully, miss any verse. Cough, tea, cigarette, never in life. I myself. No cigarette, no smoking, no meat, no cat. What is the taste of all these things? I have never tasted, never in my whole life. Or past life I've done or not. I think that also in past life. So, this process bhakti yoga is rare in this world. And anyone had to sacrifice it. Then we can follow. And that is why in this paribhasha,
definition
of bhakti, it has been told all that I am telling. Everything. But don't, devotees, they don't go deep, oh, they can fall. But what is the deep meaning? And then tell him, Anna Vilasita Sundam Jnana Karmadjana Pritam Anukullena Krishna Nusilanam Bhakti Ruttama. Bhakti Ruttama. Uttama Bhakti is Prima Bhakti. What Prima Bhakti? Prem, Sneh, Man, Pranaya, Rag, Anurag, Bhav, Mahabhav, Adhirudhan. All these are Uttama Bhakti. No? They are Uttama Bhakti. So this is the definition of Uttama Bhakti. Only the tendency and to serve Radha Krishna or his associates by all means, always, will not do. If you are doing Namabhash, Nama Parad, no Guru accepting, no in process, then worldly desire will be there. Your bhakti will be covered with jnana and karma. There will be no steadiness, no anugatya, not nirantaram, continuous, like honey. So once you should definition of this bhakti. Try to hear very attentively. We are going passing through a very wonderful process. Those who want to attain this highest goal, they must hear attentively and carefully and follow from today, not today, just made up in your mind. I will sacrifice everything that Vaishnava and Guru is telling. Not live for tomorrow, just.
Om Agnati Marandasya Gyananana Slakhaya Chakshuran Vilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Srila Gurudev ordered me to speak a few words to translate and explain the definition of Uttama Bhakti transcendental devotional service, as it has been given by Sri Rupa Goswami in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Anya bilashita shunyam jnana kama dhyanavritam anukulyena krishnana shilanam bhakti uttama. Here, in the definition, two parts have been given. The swarup lakshan of bhakti, that means the intrinsic nature of devotion, and tatastha lakshan, the extrinsic nature of devotion. In other words, what is the nature of devotional service, what it is, and also what it isn't. Both things should be understood. So first, swarup lakshan, the intrinsic nature of bhakti. Anukulyena krishna anu shilanam bhakti uttama. The continuous, uninterrupted cultivation of all endeavors of the body, mind, and words, and also of internal sentiments, which are meant exclusively for the welfare of Krishna. This is the swarup lakshan of bhakti. Here, anushilanam, this word has been given. Shilanam means a cultivation or practice. It is an activity of the body, mind, words and senses, and of moods. This activity is of two types. That is, pravritti atmaka chastarup, to accept all of those things which are very, very favorable, with a firm vow. Everything favorable I will accept in my life. And nivritti atmaka chastarup, anything which is against devotion, which will not intensify my rati, deep attachment for the lotus feet of my Ishtadev, Sisi Radha and Krishna, it must be unequivocally rejected, without a second thought. This shilanam, this cultivation of activities, should be anu. The word anu indicates a nirantara, continuously. Just as honey, when it is poured from a jar, it does not.
Now, otherwise, sit down.
Rukmini.
Don't disturb.
Sit down. Whenever you are, sit down. The word anu means continuously. How? If you pour water from a jar, it may splash here and there. But if you pour honey, it comes in a very thick stream. Even if you hold the jar like this, it will be connected all the way to the ground. There's no break, there's no interruption. So similarly, when chitta vritti, the tendency of the heart and all body, mind and senses is flowing towards Krishna without any break whatsoever at any point, this is called niranta, continuous. So we can take our own pulse and see whether or not we're performing pure bhakti. We can recognize the nature of pure bhakti by its uninterrupted flow. And anu also means anugatya, to be under guidance. Mahat kripa bina kon kame bhakti nahi, Krishna bhakti dure raha sansa nahi kshay. Oh, you may be hearing and chanting and remembering, but if you are not under the guidance of Mahat, a pure devotee who is realized in the eternal transcendental loving service of Krishna, then all of your activities, they will not be bhakti. They will be like karma, fruitive activities. And what to speak of developing love for God? You will not be able to even loosen the tight grip of the mature energy. You will be entangled more and more in so many fruitive activities in this world. Therefore, if Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam is to be performed correctly and become transcendental, then it must be done under the guidance of a pure devotee. Krishna Anu Shilanam, Krishna Anu. Pure devotional service is in connection with Krishna. It is for Krishna or in connection with Krishna. Those who are liberated completely, directly they can serve Krishna. And those who are in this world, they cannot directly serve Krishna. So how will their activities be related to Krishna? They will only be related to Krishna when their activities are related to a person who himself is related to Krishna. Therefore, for anyone's activities to comply with the definition, to enter within the definition of pure devotion, then they must be performed for those sadhak in this world under the guidance of Sadguru and Śrīla Vaiṣṇava. So anukulyena Krishna anusharanam bhakti uttama. The continuous cultivation of all activities of body, mind, words and feelings under guidance of pure devotee, rejecting all unnecessary things and accepting favorable things. It may be called uttam bhakti, but only if the tatastha lakshan, the extrinsic characteristic of bhakti, is also present. What is that? Anyabhilashita shunyam. There should not be any anyabhilas, any other desire. One may be serving Krishna, but if there's even a smell, a slight trace of any other desire in the atmosphere of one's heart, then this devotional service will not be accepted. It can never be transcendental. Anyabhilashita shunyam. Completely devoid of even the slightest smell of any other desire, except for the service of Krishna. And this devotional service should be jnana kama dhyanabharitam, not covered by karma and jnana. He Rupa Goswami Pad did not say kama jnana adi shunyam, free from karma and jnana, because no one can be free from karma and jnana. All will have to do some karma, some activity. Breathing is a karma, taking bath is a karma, using the restroom is a karma, sleeping is a karma, so you cannot be free. But some karmas will cover your bhakti. So what are they? When we're performing activities without a service mood, when we are performing activities with bhogvritti, the enjoying tendency, that by performing this activity I will receive some benefit for myself, then this will cover devotional service. And jnana cannot be free from jnana. Some knowledge should be there. This knowledge, I am the servant of Krishna, this is also knowledge, must be there. But knowledge which is nirvishesh brahma jnana, brahma jiva aikya jnana, the idea that the jiva and the Supreme Lord are one. This is impersonal philosophy. If any type of knowledge such as this is present, or the knowledge which is aimed at attaining mukti, liberation, one has desire for mukti, then this will cover devotion. So when the all desires have gone away completely, when there's no impersonal jnana, when there's no mood of fruitive activity, then if one is engaged continuously in the angas of bhakti, hearing, chanting and remembering, under the guidance of Sadguru, only then will one's devotion be called uttam bhakti, and it will produce the results of bhakti parashana bhavo birakti. One's tendency to serve Krishna, faith in Krishna, seva vritti, the tendency to serve, will intensify day by day by day. Parashana bhav, and also realization will come, and birakti. It is certain that that person will be completely detached from this world. These are the symptoms that one is actually on the path of uttam bhakti.
Even why it has been told anusilanam?
Srila Gurudev ordered me to explain the significance of anukulyana. Sometimes people think that the word anukul means for Krishna's happiness. But this is not the meaning. Why? Because we see that in the pastimes of Krishna, demons like Chanura and Mustik, they began to wrestle with Krishna. And by punching him and beating him, Krishna was very happy because he wanted to enjoy a very good fight. So though their activity gave happiness to Krishna, was it bhakti? It was not bhakti at all. Why? Because they had an antagonistic mood. They had pratikul bhav, a mood against Krishna, though their activity gave happiness. On the other hand, Mother Yashoda, when she saw that the milk was boiling over on the stove at the time when she was feeding Krishna her breast milk, at that time Mother Yashoda put down Krishna to go and stop the milk from boiling over. Krishna did not want to be put down. He was not yet satisfied. And when his mother put him down and went to take care of the milk, Krishna became upset. He became angry. He was crying even. So this activity did not give happiness to Krishna. He became angry. So does it mean that Mother Yashoda is not doing bhakti? Surely she's doing bhakti. Why? Because this milk is for Krishna. From this milk she can make kheer, rabri, and many preparations. She cannot make this from her breast milk. So it's important to save this kheer for Krishna, for his welfare in the future, his kalyan, welfare, auspiciousness. Therefore, the word anukul does not indicate for the happiness of Krishna. It means that bhakti is pratikul bhava rohita, completely devoid of an antagonistic mood. Understand? Pratikul bhava rohita, devoid of antagonistic mood. This is the meaning of anukul. Yet, we see that so many persons or things, they do not have pratikul bhav, an antagonistic mood to Krishna. For example, there are so many trees standing in the garden. They're not against Krishna. Yet they cannot be said to be performing pure devotional service. So pure devotional service is not only neutral, meaning that it is devoid of an antagonistic mood, but it is a positive engagement, a positive activity. Therefore, though bhakti was described as anukul, devoid of the antagonistic mood, Rupa Goswami, to complete the definition and make it perfect, he had to add the words anushilanam, the positive, direct engagement of body, mind, words, senses, and of all feelings, positively engaged in his service. And the degree to which the body, mind, words, senses, and feelings are engaged in his service in such a way that it is pratikul bhava rahita, that it is not against him, and it is giving him more and more joy and happiness to the point of controlling him even. That is the measurement by which different standards of bhakti can be ascertained. Because everyone's bhakti is not the same. Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, Hanuman, Chitraketu, Ambarish Maharaj, Uddhav, all of their types of bhakti are not the same. So by seeing to what degree they meet the requirement of this statement, Anukuyena Krishna Anushilanam, the constant cultivation of activities meant exclusively for Krishna, then to that degree we can understand what is the standard of their uttam bhakti.
Thank you.
Govinda Jai Jai, Gopala Jai Jai, Govinda Jai Jai, Gopala Jai Jai.
Only way, processing this, that Rupa Goswami has. Not Rupa Goswami, but even Narada Goswami has told us. Sukadeva Goswami has told us. Madhavendra Puri, Ishwar Puri, Pada, and whole of our Guru Paramahansa. This is only one process. Not by Gyan, not by Karma, not by astrology, not by yoga, not by meditation, nothing. This is the process. But this definition of bhakti is also very deep. There are three stages of this Uttama Bhakti. Three stages of Uttama Bhakti. Those who are liberated, that don't know what is Maya, influence of Maya, and they don't know this, what is the universe, Maya. And then that in the standard of actually praying, Sneha, Man, Prana, they can serve Krishna in that way. What is told in this definition? By mind, soul, body, by more than that. But those who are not liberated, they are of two stages. Sadhana stage and Pati Sadhana of this bhakti. Kriti Sadhya. Aveta Sadhya Bhava. Sa Sadhana Vida. Nitya Siddhasya. Bhavasyam. This is sadhana. This bhakti, uttama bhakti, can be done exercise only by transcendental soul. Even those who are in Vaikuntha or other planets of Vaikuntha, even they are Dwarka, Golok, Dwarka and Mathura. Oh, they cannot. They cannot. Only those who are in Braja, especially in Sakya, more in Parsad and mostly in Mathurya. Oh, they can do this bhakti. O highest goal. The mood of Radhika, like Radhika mood, serving Krishna. So this is very high. But when a conditioned soul began the practice of this process of bhakti yoga, then he will begin from his material body, material senses, and material mind and intellect. Because he has no realization of soul and all this. We are in this quarter body. We have no realization of soul. We think that this body, myself, mind is like that. So we cannot practice this bhakti yoga directly to Krishna and Radhika and to Govinda by soul. So we will begin from very last point, last fraction of the bhakti. And only by these material senses. That is why it has been told. Though not pure bhakti, but when we begin from very lowest stage or point, then with these organs, hands, we serve so much. We do archan. We hear Hari Katha. Not transcendental Hari Katha we can. No. Because these indriyas and senses are limited, covered with Maya. So we hear Hari Katha, but not her melting and weeping and rolling. This is the reason. When doing pranam, seeing deities, not that thing comes. So, kriti sadhya bhaveta sadhya bhava. For rati, that is bhav, how to attain rati? And then by exercising all our material body, senses, mind, and everything, when we practice to attain bhav, then it may be called sadhan or sadhak. Sadhan. Otherwise not. If you are chanting, hearing Hari Katha, traveling in Prajamandal, Gaudmandal, Chhatramandal, hearing so much. But your goal is not bhav, rati, then it will not be sadhana. What it will be? Nothing, zero, now. It will be about semblance of, understand? You? But what is the rati or bhav? This is the question. You.
ज्ञानतिमिदान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. सो श्रील गुरुदेव वाज डिस्कसिंग अबाउट साधन. सो जस्ट यू हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम गुरुदेव दैट व्हाट इज साधन. यू हैव टू फिक्स योर गोल. इफ योर गोल इज फिक्स टू अटेन भाव भक्ति, देन व्हाट activity, means what process you are adopting, this process called sadhana. So at first, you have to know what is bhav. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, eternal associate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has identified in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, what is that? Suddha Satta Vishesh Atma, Prema Sulijamsa Sammabhak, रुचिभि चित्तमास्त्रिणो कृदसौ भाव उच्यते. शुद्ध सत्त विशेष आत्मा, यू हैव टू नो एट फर्स्ट सत्त, देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड शुद्ध सत्त. व्हाट इज सत्त? सत्त मीन्स एग्जिस्टेंस. हु हैज एग्जिस्टेंस इन दिस वर्ल्ड, दे आर कॉल्ड सत्त. एंड आफ्टर दैट हैव टू गो लिटिल फर्दर, देन मिश्र सत्त, mixed existence. What is that? Conditioned soul. The conditioned soul, they have one idea that I am this body. They could not understand anything beyond this body and what is related with this body, they think it is all. So this is called Mishra Satta or mixed existence. After that, Shuddha Satta. Suddha Satta means pure existence, means liberated soul. So, the liberated soul, they have an idea that I am not this body, and what is related with this body, I am not related with that. I am soul, and to render service of divine couple, this is my duty. Who have this idea? They are liberated soul, and not only idea, they are practicing all these things and doing activity, performing activity, all this to make happiness to divine couple. They are called Shuddha Satta. After that, Visuddha Satta. Sattam Visuddham Vasudeva Sabditam. Who is Visuddha Satta from them? Can the who is Visuddha Satta means pure existence. From that they call Vasudeva Sabditam. That means they are Vasudev. So Shuddha Satta Visheshatma. Visheshatma means Vishesh means special way. Atma means soul. So what is Visheshatma? Here Visheshatma means Krishna told in Kar festival that Gopi is my life and Radhika Mai is life of life. So Radhika Mai Jivaner Jivan means life of life is Srimati Radhika. So Radhika is Vishesh Atma of Krishna. So when Shuddha Satta Vishesh Atma Prema Sajang Samava, when Sambit means the mood, embodiment deity of Sambit is Sri Krishna. When Sambit and Bhadini means Vishesh Atma, mix together and reflect on Sandini Shakti, in Sandhini means existence of Jiva's heart, then it is called Bhav. What is that? Prema Surjansu Sammo Bhav. This is the first ray of Prema Bhakti. Just like before sun rise, sky became red and all darkness had gone away. Similarly, before prema, the first ray of prema when reflect on devotee's heart, means in their existence and sandhini potency, that's called bhav. Suddha sapta visheshatma prema suja sammava, what will be effect of that? Ruchi vi chitta masrino. By ruchi, by taste, his heart will be completely smooth and melted, then called bhav bhakti. If you keep this in your goal, then you are practicing, then you will be sadhan bhakti. What is that? Kriti saddha bhavet saddha bhava. Kriti saddha. Kriti means carefully and kriti means senses. You have to perform all activity extremely carefully and by your senses. Kriti saddha bhavet saddha bhava. Why bhavet? To get. Bhavet means to get. What? Saddha bhava. Which is saddha bhava means attain to the goal. Saddha bhava. Nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakattam iti saddhata. The bhava is nitya siddha eternally. Eternal perfect. By your sadhana you could not change this. Only it will manifest. Just like I am giving one example, then it will be clear. Like Murari Gupta in Mahaprabhu's pastime in Navadvip, his eternal mood is to serve to Lord Ramchandra. By association of Srimad Mahaprabhu, he wanted to change his mood, but could not change with whole night. He thought, oh, I could not make happy Srimad Mahaprabhu, better I can kill myself. He arranged one sword and hide under his pillowcase. Early in the morning, before dawn Mahaprabhu arrived there, Singh Mahaprabhu, Murari Gupta became surprised. Mahaprabhu Murari, why is your anxiety? Bring that sword. What? Well, yes, which you hide under your pillowcase. Bring it. Immediate, don't delay. Then Murari Gupta brought that sword and offered to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu told Murari, you have no need to kill yourself. You are eternally associate of Lord Ramchandra. So you can serve Lord Ramchandra, no problem. So his mood is fixed here. It never be changed. Only by association it will manifest. So nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakattam iti saddhata. Similarly, all living entity has some mood. We have to manifest how? Being in good association. What is your mood? It never be changed. Who has dasa, somebody has dasa, somebody has sukha, somebody has vatsala, somebody has madhu. It will manifest only, it never be changed. We have heard from Srila Gurudev Lotus Leaf, who has in the identification of their soul in Madhurya Ras, only almost all of them can attract to us even Mahaprabhu's life, other not. Maybe there is some exception, but exception must not be exemplified. So nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakattamiti saddhata. By this way we can manifest our nitya siddha bhav by in good association, and by in good association under guidance of bona fide Gurudev, then you will be sadhan, then our life will be successful. Bancha kalpata rupasya kripasin bhayavasya kripasamanta vanyasya.
Now you can understand, even sadhan bhakti is not so easy, not easy. So I think that we are also not in sadhan bhakti too. So we are in sadhan abha. Even it may be apara. Our name is not pure. not events, it may be sadhana namapa, it may be if you will chant name of that I am this body, by my this tongue I am chanting, oh, then it may be aparadha. If you would chanting name, but taking your legs like this, not with full love and affection, as anyone serves his or girlfriend very attentively, not by laziness, by giving her heart and his heart and everything to that girlfriend, and girlfriend also gives what? Everything. Oh, more than this, Vishaya je priti ebe ache je amar, sei hote priti charanare tumar. Jivottingam katha dino. So we should try to. So chant, do all these processes in real form, real process. Even I told you sadhan bhakti, but more lower we can be. Without sadhan bhakti even, and what is that? The last fraction of bhakti is Shraddha. Don't think that Shraddha is very simple. Don't even. Worldly Shraddha, material but faith, or it is easy. And we can change it moment in moment. But transcendental faith, Shraddha, is so much steady, so much steady. And then, at that time he promises that by doing Krishna Bhakti, by everything is done. Shraddha sabde viswas kahe Krishna Bhakti Sarvakarma, my life will be successful. If I will chant, remember, and do devotional services to Krishna, my everything in my life is done. If anyone can collect so much money and becomes wealthy, is very intelligent. Wife so beautiful, husband so beautiful, children very qualified, and he has so but high class of position, but no Shraddha, then his life is
zero.
More lower than zero.
Minus zero.
Minus zero. And if there is Shraddha, not any position, he may be not so intelligent, not knowing, learning, even signing his name, no good wife, no qualified children, not wealthy, oh, he may be poorest, but he has transcendental Shraddha, then his life is successful. So you should try to know. Shraddha sabde viswas kahe sudhirdha nishya. Viswas means belief, strong belief. What? That if I will do any devotional services, surely and certainly, nishya means Definitely my life in this. This is conscious. Now you should take this skill and keep here. Really you have transcendental sadhana. And decide. If not, then come in process. Be always in high class of associates. They will give the seed of bhakti, that is this. What is seed? To serve Krishna, this desire. Really the seed of bhakti. And outer symptom is that shraddha that I told. This is transcendental shraddha. If this comes anyhow by fortunately, then your life is very tight, very tight. This is transcendental. Also this faith is of two kinds. One, Shastra Avadharanamayi and Madhujyamayi Bhav. By reading books, that if he will not see Krishna consciousness, whether you are in so much position, but you will have to go to hell. Shortly. So I must chant, whether I have taste of knowledge, I must chant, remember, and hear. And one Madhujyamayi, oh, hearing the meaning of Jasamati Nanda, Rajabharata, Gokula Ranjanaka, Gopi Paranatha, Madana Manoha. From Srimad Bhagavatam, how Yashoda Mother pointed Krishna in and how he was chastising Krishna, who Krishna, Supreme Lord, with so all kinds of opulences, and she was chastising, oh, don't come to me. I will not take you in my life. Dirty boy, naughty boy, and Krishna was on the ground and weeping, and Shiva said, oh, don't come. So, hearing this, oh, Supreme Lord is controlled by the mother love. I want to love Krishna and to serve Krishna like motherlyhood. When he heard the sweet pastimes of Krishna and gopis, Shakha, oh, their life, the cowherd boys, Gwalbal, the life of them was Krishna. They cannot tolerate a moment without the association of Krishna. Even to please Krishna, they can defeat Krishna and Krishna will be defeated. And be happy. So much happy. So I want to be a boyfriend of them, Gwalbal of Krishna, associate of Sakha, like Sakha. And I want to go to cowherd with Krishna, and Krishna will order me, oh, bring all the cows here. I will. And then Krishna will be taught, and then keeping his head on my lap. And he may sleep, and I will message him. I want to be Shakha. More than this, when he will hear the sweet pastimes of Krishna and Gopi, then, oh, Krishna will tell, you are my prana of prana, life of life. Give your sickness, otherwise I may die. keeping his two arms in the neck of gopis, begging, begging, be pleased to me. Oh, I cannot repay you, my dear gopis. I want to take your lotus feet on my head here, giving some impression that I am of gopis one. Hearing this, he decides that I want to serve O Krishna in the guidance of God. Some more, they heard the glories of especially Radhika. He is moved in Brahmargiri. He is moved in Gopi Giri. Venu Giri. And then, I want to be only maid servant of Radhika. I want to serve only Radhika. If Krishna will call, then I will come. I cannot come to you. I will not serve you. I will serve to whom? Radhika. Then he will decide, I must be maid servant of Radhika. My guru will be Vishakha and especially Roop Manjari, and they will teach me how to serve Kaliyuga. So I find if a wish has come, a desire has come, this is called transcendental madhurjamai, very high. Don't think that, this is very ordinary and very simple. Do you know? And do you want to be like that? Yes, only yes will not do. Will I give up worldly desire? You are not ready. By mouth you can. So be like that and then you can. Then Shraddha, then Anishtita Bhakti, not a steadiness in chanting, remembering, doing kirtan, and so Krishna consciousness, no steadiness. That is, Pratamkati, Utsahmai. When a guru or any pure devotee tells giving classes, bhakti is very easy. Madhura madhura me tat mangalam mangalanam sakala nigama valli satphalam chit sarupam sakita pari gitam shraddhaya deva bhrigu varnar matram taret sridhavam. Even you are chanting name, no Shraddha at all. No Shraddha, like Ajami, no Shraddha. No so much belief. Even this name you will be touched by your tongue or mind, by ear. What it is? At once, you will overcome of cross, Maya, and you will be liberated. Let me hear, like so many things. Apai tu naam spuraneena tatte prarabdha karo. So, even a tattva gyani, Brahma Jnani, he is about to liberate. He will have to test his suffer, his activities, by for which this body has been. Must, but if name comes, you will not have to suffer for any activities you have done in past, in future, in. So norm is very important. Very easy. And chant, Nityananda Prabhu has taken. This is what I'm.
Utsahamai.
Then he begins to chant. Very. But after some time, headache comes, sickness comes, and some worldly desires comes, and then you can get. Then gharna tala. There are so many. I don't want to take my time in this. I want to come just in point. I have told so many times. So I am coming. Then bhakti will come to nishtha. Nishtha means by intelligence. We will think that without bhakti nothing will be. So whether taste or not, I must chant, I must hear Hari Katha. So buddhi purvika, by intelligence we think and do. Like a medicine is very bitter, but we know that it will be very gainful for my health. We take bitter. So at that time Krishna name will be like bitter, Harikatha bitter. When you will be there, Harikatha, you are hearing, then you miss. And that is why to avoid, I tell Krishna Das and others, you should sing any song, beautiful song. And I'm all doing this. And sip this course. Otherwise you cannot hear. You cannot hear. If Tattva Gyan, what I am telling, very deep, in a moment you can see.